created some probably stomach ulcers and all kinds of digestive issues. And actually, it's turned out to be really productive too, musically. And so we've got a couple of CDs of these tunes that we've written. The most recent one is called Winter Harvest. And, it's actually back there. Or you can have that. That's cool. We're back there at the country store, and this next tune is from that CD. It's all tunes that we wrote on these Music du Jour tours. And this one is for all the, I'm sure we have hundreds of Green Bay Packer fans in the audience today. Dozens. Hey, look at, wow.
Did you grab it?
All right.
Can you grab it? Yeah, it's in the...
I was taking a big risk here. But it was inspired by watching, well, I was in Denver, though, watching the Packers beat the Chicago Bears to make it to the Super Bowl a few years ago, the AFC Championship game. And we had a gig in Fort Collins that day, and I had to write something, and I was too busy watching the game to write. But I was so excited, because it was such a dramatic win, that I think the excitement sort of turned into this tune on the drive up to Fort Collins. It's called Not Just Beer.
Yeah, you definitely need good shoes.
Chocos.
Like sneakers, yeah, chocos. Something that's like on your feet. Thankfully, that's what I have.
Right here.
Well, folks, we're going to do a tune here. I'm going to send this out to our friend Jake. Called 150 banjos. We hope that he plays all of them soon.
You run all the way over there and get out of here.
That reminds me of Sheldon. I'm not going to do that.
Thank you, Annabelle.
The dog.
right, thank you very much. We're playing instrumentals. I don't know if you noticed that. We're playing instrumental music today. But we appreciate you listening so attentively. So here's another instrumental, just in case you're wondering. They got some new laws out here, it seems like, and we heard about those. And Ross, I think before the laws came out, he wrote this tune. It's just, it's not really the same thing. This is called Medical Margarita. They have that yet? Probably somewhere. I'm not sure what it means, but I really like the tune.
What
we're going to have is a CD out next year, probably a bunch of downloads, because we've done so many of these jour gigs and written all these tunes, and we just try to record all of them, or as many as we can, and so we're going to have a bunch of stuff out there at some point, but this will be one of those. It's really fun for us to, you know, do this stuff and see what happens with the mandolin, guitar, and bass. It's just three instruments, and who knows what could happen. But anyway, this is called Medical Margarita.
No, she doesn't like those words.
Thank you.
just said, let's get weird. So I guess we'll do that. Kind of decide to feel right. So if we're going to get weird, did we already get weird? I don't know. Maybe? It didn't feel that weird, but this is weirder. So, okay, we were up in Boston. And I don't know if you've driven around Boston much or not. But it seems like even the people that live there get lost if they're driving a car. I've never not gotten lost. My wife and I go to Boston at least once a year, it seems like. And we found out that actually the roads out there are based on old cow paths. So they're not really originally meant for vehicles. It's just for cows to walk on. And so they kind of meander. And, right, Jacob? Is that right? They're just... Jacob knows. You've been lost in Boston. Dominic knows. Jeez. All these Berkeley people just showed up. Okay. So this one's gonna be a little weird. It's called Cow Paths. This one's written by Ross out driving through the Bitterroot Mountains in Montana. And it's called Bitterroot. Thank you.
it to Charlotte.
Don't worry about it.
very much. We're gonna play another old time tune here. And this is one a lot of you probably play. If you play bluegrass type music or old time music, you like to kind of play with these tunes and see what happens. So here's one called Chinkapin Hunting.
Thank you.
We'll play a couple more here. This is one that that Ross made up, and I think Ross should probably explain it because I'm not really sure what it is.
How much are they?
This is another short tune. I think it's just written up in Jackson Hole, Wyoming. We play quite often up there, and it sounded, the tune suggested a bit of an odd title, and I was thinking of odd things that I'd seen recently, and I realized that I saw a cab or something drive by with advertisements or a poster. It was actually advertising this exhibit of these ancient Chinese terracotta statues. It's the terracotta warriors. I thought it said the terry cloth warriors. I wasn't sure what that meant, but it seemed to be the title of the team. So this is the terry cloth warriors.
What is WT?
No world.
It features our bass player, Lyons own Aaron Green.
I like old food.
Thank you so much. We'll play one more for you here again. Ross Martin on the guitar, all the way from Brooklyn, New York. Thanks to Steve and Frank and everybody here at Planet Bluegrass for having us. It's really an honor to play this year. And, you know, I think it's been such a rebuild in such style. And it's so well done. It feels like a great symbol for the town of Lyons. I don't know, we're just so, amazed at the rebound. Everybody's been talking about it.
Long Planet Bluegrass.
Great job. I don't think they would have worked so hard if they didn't think anybody was going to show up. So thank you all for showing up year after year. This is a great family of musicians and fans of bluegrass. And so thank you all so much for being here. We'll be back there at the country store for a little while. Just, to say hi. So thanks so much. Here's the Lehigh Blues, and we'll hopefully see you soon.